Hi, this is Dr. Bertalan Meshko, the medical futurist, and in today's video, I want to tackle the most important topic when it comes to the future of medicine. Artificial intelligence. I guarantee you that after the next 10 or so minutes, you will have a clear picture of what AI is, how it works, where it stands today, what it's going to be, and what it all means for the world of medicine. So buckle up. When I ask people what word first comes to mind when I mention artificial intelligence, they usually say things like death, fear, or the Terminator. For a long time, we have thought of artificial intelligence as an abstract idea that belongs to the future and it will lead to something terrible, like a war against killer robots. Basically, in the past, our idea of the AI revolution was something like this. But for the same reasons why every single Terminator movie since the original two bombed and melted at the box office, we are slowly realizing that AI is a very different beast altogether. It's a nuanced subject and it will penetrate every layer of our lives almost invisibly. Today we are less afraid of robots taking our lives and more afraid of them taking our jobs. And even though we have not yet reached the state of real AI, it has already sneaked into our lives without us even noticing. I'm sure you used forms of AI even today for more than an hour. If you use Google today, the information you found was fine-tuned to your needs and habits based on your previous searches and website visits. If you used Facebook or Instagram, the ads you got were chosen based on what you said in front of your smartphone. If you used Waze or Google Maps, your route has been chosen not just to get you to your destination faster, but to optimize the entire traffic in your area. There is no person sitting behind a computer doing all these. These things are done by algorithms that continuously learn from us and about us to gradually get better and better. Moreover, from Spotify, Netflix, and Amazon to devices from Apple, Intel, or IBM, a huge amount of technologies are infused with AI. These are all examples of AI in action today. These technologies were implemented without any great announcement or fireworks. And in most cases, I expect that to be the case in the future as well. But as you can tell, these algorithms are very different from the killer robots or from the future Elon Musk is afraid of. But they are still very much AI at work. This is why I like to use the broadest possible definition when it comes to AI. Simply put, any machine that shows any intelligence is artificial intelligence. And the actual difference between today's AI and the Terminator can be found in the levels of AI rather than its definition. Nick Bostrom, the author of the fantastic book Superintelligence, has separated three different levels of artificial intelligence. First, what we have today is ANI, or artificial narrow intelligence. It refers to a computer's or algorithm's ability to perform a single task extremely well. It can play Go or chess like nobody around the world, yet its IQ is zero. In medicine, ANI can be extremely precious when it comes to recognizing patterns in huge datasets, such as radiology images or patient data. Second, what you're working towards is AGI, or artificial general intelligence. It refers to a machine's ability to understand and learn any intellectual task that a single human being can. It's basically a machine matching a human being's cognitive capacity. An example for AGI is probably HAL 9000 from 2001 A Space Odyssey, where it can navigate a spaceship, play chess, or have human conversations with the crew on board. And third, what we should be really afraid of is ASI, or artificial superintelligence. That, as its name implies, refers to a machine understanding and learning the knowledge of the entire human race, plus possibly surpassing its cognitive capacity. Frankly, our goal should be to stop right before we reach AGI, to enjoy the benefits of what AI can bring to our lives, but not reach a stage from where we don't understand what's going on around us. In movies, you have plenty of examples for any of these levels, from the Terminator to the Matrix. But it's not all doom and gloom. In real life, and in medicine in particular, if we can create machines that do certain tasks precisely, we will truly be able to do miracles. While radiologists can look at over 50 images a day, a good algorithm can be trained on millions in hours. It can go through more data in the morning than a physician can in their entire life. Now let's take a deeper look at how these things actually work them. Probably everyone heard in passing about the two most famous methods of how AI algorithms advance, which are machine learning and deep learning. Machine learning is the method where an algorithm learns from data, identifies patterns, and makes decisions with minimal or zero human intervention. It's a narrow and precise way of learning to perform a specific task. If you want an algorithm to learn to spot cats on pictures, we have to annotate millions of pictures with cats on them and let the algorithm find its own rules for spotting cats. The more data we feed it with, the better it will become at doing that task. But I have to say, there is one human element in machine learning that needs to be spoken of. Giving medical data archives to machines sounds perfect in theory, but practice is much, much more complicated. As medical data archives were obviously not created with mathematical algorithms in mind, it is a gargantuan work to try to standardize existing sampling processes or to have enough algorithm-adjusted samples. That's why data annotators are the unsung heroes of the AI revolution. They take CT or MR scans and draw lines around tumors or pinpoint cells or designate ECG strips. It's a hard and monotonous task, but it needs to be done for machines to utilize that data. Simply, data annotators are the eyes of machine learning algorithms. However, there are really complicated tasks which are hard to define. Think about spotting a tumor on a CT scan. Radiologists analyze the images, take the patient's medical records into consideration, and have to keep so many things in mind before making a diagnosis. For such tasks, we have to turn to deep learning. It's a vastly more advanced method. A deep learning algorithm can study raw MR images, or perhaps it doesn't even need images, only the raw data coming straight out of the machine to analyze it. While machine learning algorithms are blind without human help, deep learning algorithms only need annotated data until they learn to see, and then they can handle unlabeled and unstructured data without human intervention. These work based on neural networks that try to mimic how our brain processes information and makes decisions. Now, what does it all mean for the future of medicine? In only a few years, AI will start to revolutionize every area of our life, including medicine. I'm fully convinced that it will completely redesign healthcare. Let me give you 5 quick examples. 1. AI will mine medical records. The most obvious application of AI in healthcare is data management, collecting, classifying, and tracing huge datasets of already available medical information is the first step in revolutionizing the existing healthcare systems. Number 2, AI will design treatment plans. It will be able to analyze those datasets and combine them with attributes from a patient's file to identify potential treatment plans. It will take tens of millions of studies and papers into consideration while doing that. Number 3, AI will create precision medicine. Classical medical practice puts large groups of people in their focus and tries to develop clinical solutions, drugs, or treatment plans based on the needs of the statistically average person. But with the ability to analyze vast amounts of medical information through cheap genome sequencing, health sensors, and wearables, AI will most likely help healthcare move from the one-size-fits-all medical solutions towards targeted treatments, personalized therapies, and uniquely composed drugs. Number 4. AI will revolutionize drug creation. Speaking of drugs, pharmaceuticals through clinical trials take sometimes more than a decade and cost billions of dollars. AI could immensely speed up this process while making it a lot more cost-effective. This will have an enormous effect on healthcare and how innovations reach everyday medicine. Just imagine how fast we could come up with a cure for the next pandemic if supercomputers and AI algorithms could help us with the process. Number 5. Health assistance and medication management. The AI Cure app, supported by the National Institutes of Health, uses a smartphone's webcam and AI to autonomously confirm whether patients are taking their medications, or with better terms, supporting them to make sure they know how to manage their condition. This is very useful for people with serious medical conditions, for patients who tend to go against the doctor's advice, and participants in clinical trials. Of course, all this might sound too good to be true. Whenever you hear about AI, it's either getting hyped up or people try to scare you to death. And even if you don't have to worry about the Terminator, it seems a very valid worry that if the mighty AI can be even half of what it promises to be, our lives and jobs will change significantly. But let me reassure you, AI is not here to replace physicians. Instead, it's going to be the stethoscope of the 21st century, the biggest help and support a physician can ask for. Today, we have reached a level of medical knowledge where no doctor can have a grip on all 31 million medical papers out there. But AI will assist them. It will help them analyze medical data, create precision medicine, offer information about possible treatment plans and clinical trials, and so on. But these are going to be just highly advanced tools in the hands of doctors who will use them to treat and cure patients. Those who fear that with autonomous tools, machines and algorithms, the art in medicine will disappear can be reassured that it won't be the case. When an AI algorithm finds the cure but cannot explain how it did that, this task will be waiting for medical professionals. AI will bring the real era of the art of medicine. But we need to be ready. AI is going to be here faster than we can prepare for it. We need regulations, guidance, and education. As for me, I'm trying to do my small part, so you can expect a lot more videos on this exciting topic. If you want to do your part, share this video, and if you want to know more about AI, please subscribe here.